Welcome back, folks. This is Dr. Sherry Hawkins with another tutorial on WordPress. This one's going to be a little bit, cover a little bit more than the last couple. You should have at this stage, or hopefully have had by this stage, done the setup of your account in WordPress. Otherwise, you wouldn't have a site. So if you haven't done that, please go and do that. And then following on from that, hopefully you've looked at the tutorial on setting up the home page, so your basics. At this current point in time, you'll see on the screen is a home page, and hopefully all students have gotten this far before watching this tutorial. Next steps are how we'd like you to set up your layout for the associate degree program with the University College. So what I'd like you to do is set up your pages. So at this stage we just have a home page, and if I just scroll down, if it will let me click, scroll down, I've just set up the home page a little bit more since our last tutorial, saying welcome to the site, and as you can see I've added a couple of photos down here. Now the way that I did that was that I pressed the edit button and it took me here to the page where you can do an edit, and I clicked here to insert content and I clicked on add media, and then I went and found photos of myself which I had on my computer saved under pictures. I also, since last time, changed this picture just to one of the basic WordPress pictures because I was just getting a little bit sick of looking at myself every time I did a tutorial. So now we'll just do an update just in case there was any changes, and we'll go back to view page and we'll start on the next steps. So we click up here on my sites, and down here you'll see an option that says pages, and you can add pages. So we're going to go and we're going to add a page, because at this stage we don't have a page for assessments. So assessments, and this will do for the moment, publish. New page, assessments, and it looks like that has gone, well, I'm not really sure what order that's gone into at this stage, but that's okay. We'll go back to my sites and we'll go down to this menus. So down to menus on the side, and you'll see there's a primary menu, a default menu. Go to the default menu, and you'll see on the default menu that a page called assessments has now been added. So you should have a home page, an about page, an assessments page, blog page, and a contact page. What we'd like you to do now is actually grab hold of this blog page. So you need to click on blog and see how it's just going to let me move slowly and carefully up to slot underneath homepage. So it's there now, but now we want to grab hold of it again and just slightly bring it in and across, because what we're doing is a sub page. So now rather than being directly underneath, your blog page has become a sub page of your homepage. So now before we do anything else, we press save. And it's still saving. One little bit of advice is patience is critical in this whole process. So now it's saved. So you have a home page with a blog component underneath. You have an about page, an assessments page, and a contact page. Now the order is probably not that big of a deal, but we're going to click on contact. And we're going to drag that up to go underneath the About page and let go. So now the structure of your tabs, or your pages, I should say, is that you start with your home page that's got a sub page for blogging. Then we have an About page, a Contact page, and an Assessments page. What we're going to do now is save. And we need to be patient because it takes time. And I'm trying not to sing a song while it's taking time. Patience is everything. Now I'm just self-talking. When it's ready, it will, you'll see. It'll show you when it's ready. It's getting there. I wasn't going to sing, but now I am. It's taking its time. Why is it taking its time? I don't think it liked being moved. Well, it's going to have to like being moved. Maybe it is ready. Maybe it is happy. If I click over here. Oh, it seems to be happy here. Oh, and there. Yes, let's put the blog underneath. Contact, Assessments. It is happy. So now we've achieved that. We go back over to My Sites. And where it says Add Pages, we press Add. And this page we would like to call Portfolio Assessment Pieces. Now I'm just going to type in here, just as a reminder to students, these are typically assessment task one across all subjects. So let's just put that in here for now and then click publish. So now you have created another page that's for assessment pieces for assessment task one for your portfolio. Now we'll say view page. Okay, we'll come and play around with these a little bit later. We'll go back to My Sites and we'll go down to Add Pages because we want to add another page. This time it's for interim plans. So interim plans. And just as a little reminder, assessment task two. Typically your assessment task two will be to do some kind of interim plan or upload an interim plan. It may not be an interim plan, it may be some other kind of plan or a planning tool, but for this moment in time we'll call it interim plans. It can be changed down the track, but that's what we're calling it today. Publish. View page, and I think it's going to show us the shoes again because that's just a default option at the moment. Now we'll go back up to My Sites because we have one more page that we'd like to add for the University College Associate Degree Portfolio Setup, and this page is going to be Final Presentations and Pictures, and these are typically Assessment Task 3. You'll find yourself uploading little video pictures or PowerPoints, or you can upload diagrams, posters, all kinds of things. Publish this page. All we're doing at the moment is setting up, so you have your pages all set up ready to go. View page. I think we'll have shoes again, and we do. But now we would like to go back up to the top of the page here to My Sites and come down to Menus, because we need to set up the menus. Please show me the pages that I just had. Maybe we go to Default Menu. Oh, yes. Excellent. So now you'll see the home page is there. The About page is there, Assessments page, Blog, Contact, Final Presentations and Pictures, Interim Plans, Portfolio Assessment Pieces. But it does like to move things around for some reason. So what we're going to do, if this happens to you, is put things in the correct order. So underneath the home page, remember before, we actually had the blog. So we click on there and we move it up to sit under the home page. But then we need to click on it again and make it go a little bit to the right and let go so that comes a sub page. We might just save as we go here, so click save, because one of the things that I've found is that it's quite frustrating if you get all the way through half setting up a menu and your internet drops out, and the next thing you know you've lost quite a bit of time. So we don't want people to be losing time. Time's too important to be losing. So we've got home with subpage, blog, and about page. We now need to put this contacts page above the assessments, if you don't mind. There we go. And now underneath assessments, we actually want these other three pages here to become subpages. So let's just grab hold and see if it'll let us do that. Yes, it has. Click on interim plans now. So final presentations and pictures is now a subpage of assessments, but it's in the wrong order. So portfolio assessment pieces is actually up there. So grab and drag. Interim plans is actually there. And then final presentations and pictures is there, and save. So let's see what happens here. Hopefully, when we click back over here on my site, our home page up here comes up with an option to blog as well, which is great. Let's click and see what happens. Drag down my ePortfolio first blog, and it even will tell you how to get started on your first blog. So there you go, you're set up. You can do the same thing with customising here, in clicking and changing your background picture and those sorts of things. Your About page hasn't changed at this stage. Contact page hasn't changed at this stage, but Assessments page, excellent, has three sub-menus to it now. So the first one being your portfolio assessment pieces. So we scroll down. Assessment task one, it's ready to go to upload assessment pieces there. We can then also go to that menu, should click up for interim plans, and it does. And now we go on to assessments, final presentations, and it is all set up now the way that we would like it set up. The About page, we do actually want people to have a personal profile here, and there are a few different ways of doing that. So let's actually create a sub page by going down to add pages, and let's call it personal profile. Publish, view, and we have shoes, which can be changed again. But if you click on about now, note I have to go over here to my site and the menus again. And as you can see, we now have a situation where I've created the page, and I have to now go back to the default menu before we'll be able to see it. Personal profile has now come in down here. We don't want it down there, so now we go back to playing around with the ordering of the menu. This is okay. drag, we've been through this before, and underneath about. Then grab hold of personal profile, shift a little bit to the right. Blog, now that's out of whack again. We drag underneath homepage, grab hold of it, shift it a little to the right. Contact page is moved again. Grab hold of it, shift it up. There we go, we have contact page. Assessments is in the right order. Final presentations, it's not in the right order. We need the portfolio assessments up here. Interim plan, grab, drag, and now we have the correct order and the menu is set. So now we can go over here and click on My Reflective Portfolio. And it is currently on my homepage. And if we scroll down, what's it going to show us? An About page, Contact page. Where are our other pages? They've disappeared. No, they haven't. They're here. Excellent. I was a little bit worried there for a moment. So now you can see we have a personal profile page. Click. So your site is now set up, ready to go. And we'll work through some of the customising of these pages in the next tutorial. Thank you very much for your time. Thanks for listening. Looking forward to the next one. Any questions, please contact me. I'll be more than happy to help.